Hey babes, welcome back to another video. If you're new here, my name is Sierra, and if you're not, hey girl, hey. So it is a wonderful time of the year. It is Christmas, which means it is Vlogmas. So to start it off, because it's finals in with working, I can't do a video every day this Vlogmas, even though it's my first Vlogmas. I'm gonna do a video every 3 days. So this video will probably be posted December 3rd, and then I have another video December 6th. So today we are going to test, there's like 3 ingredients, which is super fun, and it is puppy chow. If you know puppy chow, you know that it really is just like chocolate covered Chex Mix, but it's fun, it's warm. So today we are going to make some. My sister is, I actually made some for Thanksgiving. I made a big bowl, and I still have some left over. Because, you know, puppy chow stays good for a while as long as you store it correctly. My sister is super sick and she wants some puppy chow. And I have all the ingredients, but I have, like, not enough to make a big old bowl of this. But she's okay because she just wants a little bit. So I'm going to show you guys how I make it. So first thing you're going to need, and I have to bend down a little bit because my phone holder, my big one broke. So this is what we're doing. This is what we're doing, though. It's going to work. So you're going to need just the rice Chex Mix from any grocery store. I think the whole box of the cereal is about $3. You'll find it in the cereal aisle. So you need that. You are going to need butter, and it can be salted butter or unsalted butter. Me personally, you'll need a whole stick of butter. You'll need half a cup of butter. Yeah, you'll need if butter, which would be bad, but I'm just using a half of a half because I don't have that much. So this is salted butter, later folks. You are gonna need semi-sweet Nestle Toll, the Toll House Nestle chocolate chips. And you are gonna need half a bag of one. So you'll just need about this much. And this much, yeah, you can eyeball it, but this much is gonna, you're gonna use almost this whole bag. Almost this whole bag. When I do a whole bit, I literally have like maybe this much left over that I don't use. But like I said, you can eyeball it. You're going to need peanut butter. You can use any peanut butter of your choice. It can be chunky peanut butter, creamy peanut butter, hypoallergenic peanut butter. It doesn't matter as long as it's peanut butter. And powdered sugar, just confectioners. It can be any type of powdered sugar, Great Value powder. I use Great Value. I use all types of powdered sugar. Usually when I bake, I use the blue bag of powdered sugar, but for this, I'm using this powdered sugar because it's just a little bit more for like a lot of consumption like this. Like you see how much I have still in there. So here's what we're going to do. So you are going to take your unsalted butter. I'm going to put it like this on top of the bowl. You're going to take your unsalted butter, which would be actually half a cup for you. But we're just doing this little bit amount for me. Half a bag of your chocolate chips. And me, I have to use the last two of what I have left in the bag. Ding, 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 ding. Okay, can you see my bowl? There we go. I hope it's not slanted of any sort, but we should be good. Okay, so I looked at my recipe. So it is half a cup of butter, which would be one stick of butter, and then 1 cup of peanut butter. And the recipe will be down below. I'll just type it out, puppy chow recipe. 1 cup of peanut butter, and then half a bag of any chocolate chips you like. It's semi-sweet, regular, whatever. And then half a bag of that. So, because I am not doing a whole, we're gonna do just enough. So I just did kind of like one. Hold on, y'all. With this bowl that has all your ingredients in it, You're gonna put it in the microwave and you're gonna stir it as it melts. So you can put it on 2 minutes, stir it in between, another minute and a half, stir it in between, and I'll be back to show you what it's gonna look like. It melted together pretty fast within a minute and a half, but because your bowl will be bigger, you can even do it on the stove top too, if you don't want to, you know, if you just want to watch it melt. And then you can stir it, because as you know, chocolate kind of melts within its own chocolate, within its own heated up chocolate. So you can take it out and stir it up, and it's such a quick and easy, I'm telling you, I love the puppy chow that I bought from the store, and it was just like my favorite because I love chocolate, peanut butter, all like that. But then I was like, I'm like so into baking now that I'm like, I want to know how to make this on my own, so I don't have to like keep buying it like, and now I can eat it in bulk, and it's addicting. Let me tell you right now, it's addicting. So, and everyone's gonna love it if you're taking it to a Christmas party, or if you're taking it to, you know, just to hang out with friends or family. Everyone is gonna love the puppy chow and they're gonna be addicted. When I first told my family that I made it from scratch, they laughed and was like, Sierra, you just be making stuff. And I was like, just wait till you try it. Now my sister's sick, like, can I have some puppy chow? Can you make some? Yeah. And it melted very easily. Okay. So here we go. We are going to get a bigger bowl. I'm going to be so mad at me for using all these bowls. That's the one. Okay. So you're going to take a bigger bowl. I got this bowl from Target. It was on sale for $3. It's a super durable baking bowl and I love it. So you're going to take your Chex Mix. And you are going to put it in your bowl. And then you're just going to pour your chocolate all over the top. And then you're just gonna mix it up. And it will mix very well. Just give it some time. Some of the pieces will like crunch up at the bottom or even break, but that's even better because when they get covered with the powdered sugar, they're gonna turn into their own little pieces. And who doesn't like little extras? Okay, so as we're turning you can see that it's pretty well coated in the chocolate just that fast. So you can keep turning it how you'd like it. And then boom. Now look. So you can keep turning it how you'd like it. Like that. I'm pretty sure y'all gonna see banana pudding on this show too, because my mom been bugging me about some banana pudding. Okay. So next, after it's all mixed up in the bowl, this is what you're gonna do. And this is the end up. You can take a plastic Ziploc bag if you have one, a big one. But if you're making a lot, it's easier to just get yourself 2 Walmart bags. Well, these are pick and save bags. I would not use Walmart bags because y'all know. They're just they say too sanitary, but you know, when it comes to pick and save, you'd be pretty okay. Or a lot of times I will use Woodman's Fresh Thyme, just because you know they just probably have a little bit of cleaner environments. So this is what you're gonna do. So you got your bag and you double bagged it. Right, and you double bagged it. Now you're gonna pour your Chex Mix with the chocolate into the bag. Don't even think about it, just pour it. You scrape it all in there. Don't even think about it. Just pour it. Just pour it. Now that that's poured, you can start to soak that with some hot water. Now you're gonna take your powdered sugar and you're just gonna dump until your heart feels that it would all be covered. So you don't have to use a lot. The extra sugar will always just come off at the bottom anyway, so it'll be fine if you put too much. So here's how this looks. Just like that. So now you are going to, and you'll be able to add as you go too, because this is a super easy process. So now what you do is you'll tie up the bag and you're just gonna shake it. You're just gonna shake the powdered sugar around onto the Chex Mix, like, until it gets all coated. You're just gonna shake it. Just like that, right? Boom, plop it down, we're gonna open it. Oh my God. Ha, amazing. Now, you have puppy chow. Let me show you. Puppy chow. To perfection, just like that. Three ingredients, let me see. Butter, no, four. Four ingredients, about five steps, quick and easy. You got homemade puppy chow. And your family gonna fall at your feet. They're gonna be calling you. They're gonna be calling you. So now I'm about to show you, because this bag is still good. You can just take any Tupperware that you have. I like this one. You can throw that second bag away. Let me see. And you just dump it in there. No puppy chow left behind. And now you've got puppy chow. Now you can add in M&Ms or whatever. You can add in pretzels. I know a lot of people like pretzels in their puppy chow. Now you can add anything you want. You can make it Christmas themed and add sprinkles. Whatever you need, but now you've got, and that was a lot. So, and I mean, that was a good amount. And so if it's just you, you can follow the recipe I did with just the 1/4 cup of butter and the 1.5 ice cream scooper. And just, you know, eyeball these, but follow the recipe of, so good. I'm telling y'all, it's so good. So you'll follow the recipe of 1/2 cup of butter, 1 cup of peanut butter, and 1/2 bag of these Nestle chocolate chips. And then you're gonna need, trust me, and if you're making a bigger size, you're gonna use a lot of your powdered sugar. But like I said, it all comes off at the end if you use too much, so it's not a problem. And this powdered sugar, I'll even probably pour some more in here just so my sister has a little bit of extra. Because who doesn't like extra powdered sugar? And you're all done, and now you have puppy chow. So I hope you guys enjoyed this quick, simple, easy Christmas festive warming treat recipe. And I'll be back with plenty more in 3 days.